What's up, guys? MKBHD here. And this week, the iPod Touch got an update. And possibly the last iPod update ever. Also, yes, this is an Austin Evans video title. And yes, I asked him if I could use it, and he said yes. So thanks, Austin. Okay, so the iPod was, I think, Apple's first really super massive hit. You know, they had other popular products, but I remember a time in high school when literally everyone I knew either had an iPod or wanted one. They were ubiquitous. Also, fun fact, the first piece of tech I ever bought with my own money, you know, this was back in high school with my allowance money, before I had a channel, before I made any videos, but I was into tech, my first piece of tech was an iPod Touch, you know, back with the 30 pin and everything. So the iPod Touch was really near and dear to my heart. Then like a week later, it got stolen from my locker in school. So, good times. But then of course, as we all know, the iPhone launched, combining the iPod with a couple of other things.
An iPod, a phone, and an internet communicator. An iPod, a phone. Are you getting it?
And then the rest is history. That absolutely took off. We all know what the iPhone turned into, and it sort of pushed over the iPod as Apple's new baby. And it's dominated ever since. Even to this day, in 2019, 60% of all of Apple's revenue comes from iPhone sales. Now the iPod's not even listed up at the top of the categories on Apple's website anymore. Feels kind of like this retired category. You kind of have to actually dig to find them and buy them. And so this past week, Apple updated one. And if you search iPod on apple.com, you can find them. So why? Well, this is it. So I bought the new Product Red 2019 iPod Touch at the new baseline of 32 gigs of storage for $200. And on paper, it's barely an upgrade. It's mainly just this spec refresh in the exact same design it's had for the past couple years. So now it's rocking an A10 Fusion chip. So yes, the chip from the iPhone 7, but that is still a pretty big upgrade. And then it still has 1 gig of RAM, still the same 1,043 milliamp hour battery from the past few years, still the same 4-inch LCD Retina display, same home button with no Touch ID, no Face ID, same 8-megapixel rear camera with a little camera bump, and same huge white bezels on the front of every single one except the space gray model, and the same 1.2-megapixel selfie camera up front that they've always had since the beginning. And it still has that same plastic sort of cutout hole punch on the back of the all-metal iPod for GPS and other antenna signals to pass through instead of building, you know, antenna bands on the outside like every other device nowadays. So now knowing all this and actually having held it and felt it, like, the question is super obvious. Why would anyone in 2019 buy a new iPod Touch, especially at $200, $300, even $400? But it's actually a little more reasonable than you might think. Well, except for the $300 or $400 variants. You should probably pretty much never have any reason to buy those. Like, it's just straight up robbery. You should just buy a used iPhone 7 or something at that price instead. So that's dumb. But the $200 one, that's a real thing. So first reason someone might buy this and not an iPhone is actually specifically because it's not an iPhone. Lots of people, whether you agree with it or not, want to get their kids a piece of tech, but they're too young for an iPhone or not responsible enough to have a phone yet. So they get an iPod to listen to music and mess with apps and games and get familiar with technology, watch videos, but they can't text or make calls like an iPhone would, but it still has iMessage and FaceTime and things like that to stay in touch with mom and dad and friends, when they're on Wi-Fi anyway. But yeah, that's a whole category. So that's people who don't already have a primary smartphone. But even if you do already have a phone, the iPod Touch is, of course, much smaller. I, for one, definitely forgot how small this is. Like, I don't know about you, but I always thought of the iPod Touch as the biggest, chunkiest iPod. I remember the iPod Nano was great for, like, armband size or working out or running. The iPod Shuffle was always tiny. So it seemed like the iPod Touch was this big, unwieldy iPod. But even today, people go running with their phones that are massive, but if you compare them today, the entire iPod Touch from 2019 fits inside just the screen of the iPhone XS Max. It's just such a drastic difference. But yet the iPod's 4-inch screen, while it's technically smaller than the one on the front of the Galaxy Fold, the aspect ratio is much more standard. It's 16:9, so it's not impossible to type on. You still feel like you can use it normally. So this is truly one of the last devices other than like the Palm phone, with a screen that you can actually reach all four corners without struggling. And also my favorite part is holding it in my hands kind of makes my hands look just absolutely massive, like Shaq's hands. You know that clip of him holding a perfectly normal sized water bottle? Yeah, I feel like this iPod makes my hands look that big. But anyway, it's extremely thin and light, as you could probably guess from the 1000 milliamp hour battery or so, but going running with it is no problem. You can hold it or have it in your pocket or an armband. That is the advantage this has over anything else, is just being so portable. And then of course, yes, that headphone jack is so important as a media player. And yes, it comes with, as you saw, wired headphones in the box in 2019. So yeah, it's just really good for people who can't have a phone yet or don't have a phone yet that does everything this does. But even for people who do already have a phone, this is the only iPod left. It's the last iPod. And iPods are just for playing music. So whether you use Apple Music or Spotify or whatever else, SoundCloud, doesn't really matter. It's kind of still all happening in the cloud. So you don't usually need more than the 32 gigs of storage it starts with. You're set. I actually got my grandfather one of these a couple years ago, the last gen, specifically so he could listen to whatever music he wanted at any time. So it's crazy. His music experience went from radio to just record players to tapes and CDs to just literally having whatever song you want on demand at any time. That's pretty crazy. So as a music player, the iPod still does the job. Other than that, you know, the camera, it's a nice to have, but it's not that great. The selfie camera is obviously not great. It's 1.2 megapixels, but it's not even about the megapixel count. It's good enough for FaceTime or to take a perfectly average selfie. It's nothing spectacular for $200. And despite the abysmal specs on paper, this is a prime example where the numbers really don't tell the whole story. It still opens apps quickly and scrolls smoothly, and it's more than enough to just listen to music. And it's an excellent iPod. Oh, plus it's a bonus if you're a developer, you can just have a throwaway iPod as a device with the latest version of iOS to test things on. So is this the last iPod update ever? I don't know. I don't think anyone outside of Apple really knows the answer to that question, but it sure feels like they've been slowly winding down that whole category for a while now. But yeah, this really takes me back to, you know, those days of my first ever pieces of tech I ever got, and the craziness of having all the songs you want in your pocket with an iPod. Also, something I didn't tell you, after I didn't have my iPod Touch anymore, a couple months later, I went out and got a Zune, my Zune HD. And I actually really liked that thing. The Zune HD, it was matte black. It had this little OLED display, black bezels. So it was just sort of like this floating, super simple UI in the air. I actually really liked that. I don't know, I'd kind of go for one of those again, but anyway. RIP Zune. Anyway, that's why the brand new iPod Touch still exists in 2019. I could actually see people buying the $200 one, not the $300 one, not the $400 one. Don't get those. But if you get one, you could probably keep one of these around. Either way, thanks for watching. Catch you guys in the next one. Peace.